flood the blocks.
We're on the Infinite Daps tour, which is Baauer, RL Grime back to back, me and Jim-E-Stack as supporting acts.
Me and Harry, like ever since we met, we've always like been close. I brought up the idea of doing a back-to-back with them, and they loved it. Me and Harry both have been fans of Ryan and Jim-E's music for the longest time, so it just kind of fit perfectly.
I've known Harry for a while. They just hit me up asking if I wanted to be support, and they're good friends of mine, so it's a no-brainer.
When the idea came about, it was just really natural. It seemed, of course, we should all go on tour and put together a really cool show and go visit some new cities that we've never been before.
We're just hitting more Midwest states, but I think together we kind of unite and help each other out and play bigger shows around here.
Before hopping on this tour, I definitely like put together a loose group of songs that I know I'm gonna play pretty much every night. Sometimes just reading the crowd, you change one thing here, one thing there.
There's a lot of different ways of going about playing a set. I try to play a bit of everything slow and fast. It is hard to stay on top of everything while you're playing, and because a certain venue in that city, like everything could be totally different.
I'm going to try Hemsworth and play some music.
If it's the right people in front, then they're going to get excited and they're going to make the people behind them react. And then you're gonna feed off of it.
I've known Ryan for a while.
He like really inspired me the way he puts a set together. It's more than just the DJ set. It's like a Ryan set. It's like you're getting all of Ryan.
Harry and I, we just have a really similar ear for music, so it's cool to be able to like play a set with him, play stuff that we're both fucking with, and see people also vibing on it.
What the fuck is up right now, Mason? Come on.
Like top three hottest shows I've ever played.
That was so fucking hot!
Dudes, we all kind of change a bit when we're on stage. It's a huge release when we can go on stage and connect with people in such a big setting.
Hey guys.
I didn't really grow up in the club scene. I came more from a rock background. So I think that kind of influences more of the emotional, moody side of my music that people seem to find. I'll put Kenny G with ASAP Ferg and a song from Pokemon with an R. Kelly song. Any DJ wants to do that, make people experience new sounds and new music. My generation kind of entirely grew up in that same way. We all listened to Third Eye Blind, but we also all listened to Beastie Boys, and we kind of like all these different genres, and I think that's why I can do okay by mixing everything together.
Thank you guys.
We're all kind of in the same mindset that's like, we enjoy turning down. We're all mellow guys, so it seems kind of weird that we would be just like so energetic and stuff, but it's cool to have this like hour and a half, 2 hours out of the day that's just pure energy.
Me and Henry would try out a lot of new shit. He's a wizard at cutting together two different tracks and basically making a new track. We would use everything, just stuff that we liked. We both were really like, damn, remember Beamer, Benz, and Bentley? Like, how sick was that tune? So then just like, hey, let's fucking play it. I know this drop goes off, but let's cut it together with this fucking Genuine, and then it becomes something totally different.
Step really hard for you to get up on.
Yeah.
That was like really struggling.
That was really tough.
That was embarrassing. We like went up in the front of the stage to go give like Infinite Daps at the end.
Oh yeah, that's that.
But there was like a crucial low step to get up to the high stage, and we were both like kind of struggling to get onto it.
Infinite Daps, all four of us really respect each other musically and personally and, you know, emotionally. It's sort of a cohesive group of people, and I thought that was a cool name for the tour.
Best night of my fucking life. You guys are awesome.
Welcome to Full Throttle Indoor Karting, racing like you've never experienced. Here are a few things to know before you get on the track. And remember, safety is our number one priority. The gas is the green pedal on the right, and the brake is the red pedal on the left. The seats and pedals are adjustable. The black flag is for a penalty or a problem. If it is shown to you rolled up, that is a warning. Clean up your driving. All racers are required to wear a full face helmet and neck collar. Put on your head sock, then select a helmet that provides a snug fit.
Oh, right.
There's two of them there, you have to go.
Right, top.
And just like wiped the floor with us. He was fully suited up, ready to go.
I love the go-karting, like that was exhilarating for me.
I was Victor, but I played a lot of Mario Kart, so I knew what I was doing.
I tapped Harry in the back a few times.
No.
You do a Tokyo Drift at all? Like, I felt so tired doing that.
So I know that.
four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Turn my music high, 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 high,
everyone's very low-key on this tour. Even if there was an after party, we'd rather just go and fucking pop in a DVD.
We all were kind of trying to eat somewhat healthy while we were, I mean, it's hard obviously when you're, the hours even that we're awake were so weird. I'd wake up at like 3 p.m. and then we'd go to bed at like 6 or 7 a.m. So it gets weird.
Breakfast stuff.
Uncrustables and chocolate milk.
One snack. My guilty food pleasure would be Uncrustables. Just classic peanut butter and jelly, just like your mom used to make it. Just so classic. After a show, there's nothing like putting that nice disc in your mouth.
Ooh, I like that one.
I'm Michael Washington, welcome to Jackass.
Jimmy, we're in St. Louis right now. Do you have any fun facts or anecdotes about St. Louis?
I saw a cardinal today.
You heard it here first, Jimmy Stack saw a cardinal today.
St. Louis, press
everyone,
your hands up.
Everyone, get your ball looking. Middle fingers in the air.
You're at 1545 North Broadway, Smokey O's Barbecue, St. Louis, Missouri.
Smokey O is what they call St. Louis Barbecue. And once they try it, they gotta come back.
What can I get for you this evening?
Do you recommend the pulled pork or the beef brisket?
Beef brisket.
All right, I'll do that.
I like them.
Can I get ribs?
And what would your two side items be?
Beans and cornbread.
Smokey O's was super good. People definitely pride themselves on their own barbecue, and it's nice to like stop in and actually have a real like meal that's that city's meal. I got like just a pulled pork sandwich, mac and cheese, and cornbread, and tried to just get as much fat, greasy stuff as I could.
Dabs on fucking dabs on dabs on motherfucking dabs.
We got that SHLOHMO, SHLOHMO. Fucking, we goes hard out here.
5 minutes.
Okay.
middle of nowhere about to shoot some guns.
Lord.
This is the shooter's resting position. You know, it's a good piece of steel.
Harry, Harry, Harry.
Deep breath.
Pull!
Still.
Whoa! Yay! There we fucking go.
Pull!
Ryan!
Pull!
Oh! Oh!
He's a natural.
Oh.
Who would have thought?
Oh my god. Don't mess with Jimmy. First time, not my last.
They're clearly like waiting for you guys.
Yeah.
Pretty clear.
Whoever, like the sound guy, is playing off of my iPad to do this changeover music right now, and he's playing my nighttime playlist. So these are all the tracks I fall asleep to. So it's a little hard to get in the zone right now. It reminds me of my band so much. 'Tide Rush. I love Frank 151 magazine.
We're in Omaha, Nebraska, man. All of us here, we're all beautiful people. Come to Omaha and check us out. Check our bands, because our bands are beautiful. 100. Deuces.
Awesome to be able to do this type of thing with friends. Sometimes it's a really industry-made thing, like you're just forced to do a tour with somebody. To be able to just like go with like some best friends is such a luxury.
This tour's just been a really great experience for me. I like kind of doing something where it's, you know, a designated couple weeks where you just go hard.
Every show was packed and super live. I was so blown away. It was nothing of what I expected, that, you know, we could reach this far to cities that I had never been before.
Going on a bus tour
it kind of seasons you for touring, like, for the rest of your life, because you're just, like, kind of thrown into this situation where every single night you have to, like, give 100% for, like, an hour and a half, and it's made me, like, a better DJ, and obviously I became much closer to all the guys on the bus.
Hi!
This is RL Grime. This is Baauer. Thank you guys so fucking much, for real. We love you. Everyone have a good night.
Throw it up if your name Jim-E-Stack, put your hands in the air. Name Jim-E-Stack, put your hands in the air.
Harry Rodriguez!
Oh, Bumble Clutch.
Taji, 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 Taji.
Put your hands up if your name's Harry right now. Put your hands up.
Taji!
Jim-E-Stack!
It's so loud.
That frisbee.
See you next time. When we talk about it, we'll be about it, and we'll stunt about it, and we'll see you there.
Woo!